Hello, everyone. So this is me. Sorry. So this is me bent over, literally vacuuming this street. And what I'm doing here, aside from my best Ghostbusters impression with my vacuum, is that I am after the gunk, or the dust that accumulates on the streets. Now I do this by vacuuming back and forth across the road, then I empty the contents of my vacuum cleaner, and what I get is this. Now this is urban road dust, and by studying its composition, I could better understand the science of the total environment. All I mean by this phrase is that almost every single activity that happens within Philly will somehow or another leave a trace within road dust. So everything from cars driving by and generating brake wear to secondary products from industrial or commercial activity, all of this will find its way within road dust. The key point here is that in this way, road dust acts as a sink for pollutants. So all types of dangerous activity that happen within Philadelphia will find their way within road dust, and then itself in itself becomes a source for pollution because it could be transported, it can be moved around. Now, Philly's actually the perfect place to study road dust, first and foremost, because it used to be known as the workshop of the world. It has a long industrial history associated with it, and at one point in time, there were 36 active lead smelters within the city's limits. Now, all of this activity absolutely could accumulate within road dust to what I find today. Now, people are exposed to road dust on a daily basis. So just by walking down the street, maybe even to this auditorium today, you may have been exposed to road dust. And this happens through ingestion, through inhalation, and through dermal contact. This is so important as well because children are exposed to road dust at a far higher rate than adults do, simply put because they like to play and they like to stick their hands in their mouths. So because of their high rates of hand-to-mouth contact, it is crucial to understand exactly what is present within road dust so we know what our children are being exposed to. Now, Philly also has a variety of traffic represented within the city. And what I mean by that is that there are some very quiet streets with few cars per day, as well as there are some very busy streets as well. So that I can study road dust at both of these types of locations, compare their compositions, and see if that factor makes a difference. Now, these are the 30 sample sites that I selected throughout Philadelphia, and you'll see them with the dots. And the colors of the individual dots, so here, green, this just means low traffic. So this is few cars per day, whereas yellow is medium traffic and red is high traffic. I also selected for a variety of land uses. So land use just being whatever activity happens closest to where I sampled the road dust, whether that be a park, residential activity, or commercial activity. Now, when I got these road dust particles and when I started looking at them, what became so clear was that there was a lot of lead present. And you'll see this with the two lead particles that I've shown here on the left and on the right. And so these images are generated from electron microscopy. So I take the road dust, bombard it with electrons, and then the way that these electrons scatter across these particles back into the detectors allows us to build the images that you see here. Now, the two key points from these images are first and foremost, these particles are small. Small enough that they could be transported, small enough that they could be health relevant, maybe they could be inhaled, ingested, and interacted with. Now the second important point is by studying their shape or their morphology, we could trace this back to the source of this dust. And in this case for these lead particles, they are related to the formerly mentioned smelting activity as well as to the breakdown or the erosion of lead paint from older homes. So just by looking at these particles, we could understand where they come from, as well as if they are dangerous to us, which they absolutely are. Now, I also looked at road dust by the different land use types that I studied. And I did that with these box and whisker plots here. So I just have the amount of lead or concentration on the y-axis, and then I look at this by the five different land use types. So I have commercial land use, which is just storefronts, industrial land use, which is more like factory settings, and then mixed park and residential settings. Now the box and whiskers, really they're showing us the spread of the data or kind of where all of the lead concentrations lie. But what I want to focus on are these white dots here, which just show mean or average lead concentration. And what I found is exactly what I expected, which is that the most lead was found at industrial land use sites. So this is intuitive, as we would expect the potential source of this lead to be the most polluted. Now, I also looked at these results by traffic, and this is actually what I did not expect these results. What I expected to find was that the highest mean concentration of lead was at high traffic sites. Simply put, more cars, more pollution. But this was not the case. What I found, as you can see here, is that the highest mean concentration of lead was actually at lower traffic sites. And this could be one of the reasons is that perhaps if there are fewer cars per day, maybe the road dust is being transported less, maybe it has more time for it to accumulate and to build the concentrations that I found when I sampled these locations. But overall, road dust is absolutely a sink for pollutants, which was demonstrated with the vast amount of lead particles that we found with electron microscopy. And from those particles, I was able to source it back to smelting activity as well as to the breakdown of lead paint. Now, road dust is also in itself a source for pollution, and we did find that the composition of it did change with factors that we looked at. So it changed with land use activity, as well as it changed with traffic activity. Now, overall, all of this information will be used going forward in order to inform future regulation to make public health relevant decisions to best protect the citizens of Philadelphia. So with all that being said, I hope that when you walk home today and you're crossing the street, you look down at the gunk, you remember it and its importance. And then maybe when you see me running around with my vacuum cleaner early in the morning, you just give me a little wave. Thank you so much.